A quarter of adults in Britain are so obsessed with cleaning and tidying that they spend 2.5 hours or more every weekday on household chores, with many feeling compelled to abide by strict regimes and rituals.
I iron my duster. That represents order and sanity.
I do find myself going over something which I know is already fine. It doesn't hurt to just make sure it's fine again.
Knowing that my home's clean and tidy, it is like a feeling of euphoria.
But for most of us, keeping our homes clean and tidy is not a priority. With 7 in 10 Brits saying they can't find the time to vacuum, dust or clean the bathroom.
I am stood in poo.
And 500,000 washing their bed sheets just 3 times a year.
How do you change the bed?
You don't.
Yeah.
Can a group of obsessive cleaners transform the habits of a nation?
The moths have already taken to it.
Just makes me feel a bit...
I think I'll knock with me feet.
Or will changing the lives of those with a very different attitude to cleanliness prove too much for the people whose need for perfection?
Do you mind if I just step out? Just the sheer smell.
Has become an obsession.
It just feels so dirty. I feel vile.
They're all over the work surface and it's just something that I couldn't deal with.
You're just walking off like some sort of...
Clive needs to put his hand down his pants, find his balls and make a decision.
Just like everything to look perfect, everything to look like a show home. That's what I try to achieve all the time.
32-year-old sales rep Louise Alamano from Darwen, Lancashire, spends nearly 30 hours a week keeping her 2-bedroom house up to standard.
If I see any little bits on the floor, then what I'll do is I'll go down on my hands and knees and I'll literally lick my finger and just pick the bits up.
Louise goes through 2.5 litres of bleach a day to ensure her home is always pristine.
I wipe the worktops down every time I come into the kitchen, and probably in a day, 8 to 9 times. Putting my cloth away, I can then drip water on the floor and I'll have to start the process of cleaning the floor again, even though I've probably already just done it. It can take me a while to leave the house. It's about walking back into the house and everything just being absolutely perfect. Otherwise, I won't be able to stop thinking about it whilst I'm out. I call these my buffing socks. Once I've cleaned all the floor, I literally go around and buff the floors really hard, and then they come up really, really shiny. They turn out to be the best Christmas present I could have got.
Louise insists on the house being as free of clutter as possible.
There's no way you can clean properly if you've got things piled up and on shelves and on windowsills.
Which means bedside tables are banned.
The less things that are in the bedroom, the less dust there is.
And even her 4-year-old daughter's teddies are targeted.
Every couple of weeks, I'll go through her soft toys, I'll put them in a charity bag, put them in the garage for a couple of days, and if she doesn't notice, then I put them out to the charity shop. So far, I've managed to get away with it.
But not everybody appreciates her relentless routines, including husband Luke.
A lot of our friends say that she's mad for the amount of cleaning that she does do. She's quite a nightmare, to be honest with you. Just when you're relaxing, watching a little bit of golf on the settee, and then all of a sudden she just starts coming around and actually tidying up behind you.
Now Louise is leaving her family and immaculate home to come to the aid of someone who lacks her obsession with cleaning.
Hopefully I can help somebody and maybe change somebody's life just a little bit and really come away not so stuck in my ways.
Hopefully she's not going to come back any worse. I don't think she could come back any worse, to be honest with you.
Louise is travelling 260 miles from Lancashire to Portsmouth. ...65-year-old Tim Viney lives by himself in this 3-bedroom semi.
This house is a mess. It's horrible. I can't have people in because I'm ashamed of what this house looks like.
Since separating from his wife 7 years ago and with his 2 children grown up, Tim has been living an extreme bachelor existence.
When I bring the washing in, I tend to just put it on here. because I'm probably going to need it again soon. This stuff has been here since months. It's been here probably since 4 months.
The kitchen only gets a proper clean at Easter and Christmas when family come back to visit.
The sink has got these horrible black marks. That's tea stains. There's stains that have trickled down. Sometimes I look at it and I just feel disgusted with how I've let it get. And it does bother me then. But then the next morning I get up and go to work and it's still the same.
Tim works 30 hours a week at a holiday camp as a cleaner.
I couldn't get up in the morning and say I'm going to clean the house from top to bottom because I wouldn't have enough hours in the day. I wouldn't even get through one room because I'd get sidetracked. I'd pick up something and I'd think, oh, where am I going to put this?
Hello, Dad.
One of the only people allowed to see inside the house is Tim's disabled daughter, Lisa.
Not too bad. There's clutter everywhere. Clothes, papers, books.
If I'm having a bad day with my cerebral palsy, then it is more difficult.
You do need help now to get it sorted out.
I just can't do it on my own. I know I would never do it on my own.
It's got to that state where he just probably doesn't know where to start.
It's not comfortable. No room is comfortable. I've got to deal with it. I know I have. Otherwise it just gets worse.
Louise has just 4 days to help Tim restore order and deep clean his home.
Hello.
Hello.
And Louise.
Oh, Louise, I'm Tim. Pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Tim. Are you OK?
I'm not bad, thanks. A bit nervous.
No, we're both nervous, don't worry.
Come in. This is the main room.
I've never seen so much stuff.
It's
just
it's,
piled up.
I bring things in, I put them down and they just stay.
There's no way I could sit and relax with that there. That there.
This is my kitchen stroke dining.
Oh, my goodness. So why is all the washing here?
If I need anything, it's there. I'll just take it off, quick iron, and I'm wearing it.
How can you clean this properly on a regular basis with this much stuff?
It doesn't get cleaned on a regular basis, I'll be honest. It gets a proper clean about once, twice a year.
Once, twice a year for
a year.
Kitchen?
For a kitchen.
The sink, when did you last clean this?
Christmas, which is seven or 8 months ago. Yeah.
Why don't you just do it? It's woulda, coulda, shoulda. Just do it. Oh, my God.
This is the bathroom, Louise.
Oh, Tim, this is bad. It's just horrendous.
Well, no, it's bad. I know it's bad.
If you know it's bad, then why not just clean it? I just don't understand. Oh, my God, look at your sink. Well, how can you possibly wash yourself in here? Seriously.
I just stand in there and I run the shower. I do, just stand in there and run the shower.
I'm shocked. It's a lot worse than expected. I think Tim's in massive denial about his situation. I think he does need a bit of a wake-up call. I think it's time for it and time to change his life.
Louise wants to give Tim a taste of the cleaning regime she employs at home.
I'll do at least an hour, hour and a half in the morning before I go to work. I'll always hoover from top to bottom twice a day. I'll hoover all the kitchen floor, and then what I'll do is I'll bleach it on my hands and knees with a cloth. I don't use a mop and bucket. And then what I'll also do, once the floor is dried, I'll go down on my hands and knees, and if I can see any little bits, I'll lick my finger and just even the tiniest little crumb or piece of dust or whatever, I'll pick that up.
And this is every day?
Yeah. I do the kitchen worktops maybe 5 or 6 times a day, and then I come back in the evening and I'll do at least an hour, hour and a half.
I just can't believe anybody would spend that much time cleaning. That cleaning regime is just unbelievable.
It's going to need a lot of bleach, an awful lot of bleach.
In a recent survey, 42% of Brits said they'd never cleaned their home from top to bottom. But there's a unique group of individuals who are obsessed with keeping where they live spotless. At the age of 75, Victoria Burton from Southend in Essex still racks up over 40 hours of cleaning a week to keep her 9-roomed house spick and span.
My cleaning day never ends, so up till 2 o'clock in the morning, I can't help it. I can't relax until everything's perfect. The lady next door thought I was mad when I went out on the roof, sweep the roof, yeah. And she shouted out, why isn't your husband doing that? I said, because you don't do it properly.
I iron absolutely everything, even my duster. That represents order and sanity.
In her almost 60 years of practice, she's developed some special cleaning methods.
I feel I've got the cleanest toilet in the whole street. I like to clean all the water up, every single drop.
Then I scrub right under there.
When these weren't so difficult, I always used to take this off as well and wash the ball cock. My husband says to me, I think your toilets must be cleaner than Buckingham Palace's toilets. I thought, wow. I like to clean my shower, either my underwear or my swimming suit. I don't know what the average Joe Bloggs does. Whatever it is, I don't do it.
Grandchildren have been at these because I'd like to have them in order.
They're not just anywhere. I'll have you know, they're from Harrods.
Victoria is leaving the household chores to husband Michael while she helps a stranger get their home in order.
I really passionately feel that I can help somebody get a better life. Failure with this clean is not going to be an option.
She's very forthright and straight and direct. A bossy bitch. So if people don't try to help themselves, then you'd find that frustrating, wouldn't you?
Very.
Bye, darling.
Victoria will be taking her 8-hour-a-day cleaning habit from Southend-on-Sea to Castle Bromwich in the West Midlands.
Housework has always been a swear word in this house.
Computer technician Leslie Rice hasn't given her three-bedroom flat a proper clean in the 19 years she's lived there.
You don't eat off the floor, so does it matter if the floor's a little bit dirty? Cooker's a bit grim, but the cooker doesn't have to be that clean because the food's not touching it.
Although the landlord fitted a new kitchen just over a year ago, it hasn't prompted Leslie to clean up her habits.
There's not 19 years of rubbish in the cupboards in here, but obviously there's 19 years of grime on the ceiling and walls.
56-year-old Leslie suffers from a variety of health problems, pushing cleaning down her list of priorities.
This is my salubrious bathroom. It's just a case of it needs a damn good clean.
But motivating her now to do something about the state of the flat is the fact that her daughter, Christine, is uncomfortable about her children visiting.
I don't really want to let them play here because of the amount of bacteria and stuff that's probably lying about everywhere.
So, Nan, your house is a mess. Where's the vacuum?
My mum's a perfect nan. She needs to get it sorted so she can spend as much time as she can with the kids.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Leslie.
I'm Victoria.
Lovely to meet you. Like to come, sir?
Oh, my goodness me. I hope you've got a lot of elbow grease in you. Certainly going to need it.
Mm-hmm.
Grief. My goodness.
Yes, I know.
Haven't you heard of paint? Or just wash it? There'll be some improvement.
Yes, but it's getting down on my hands and knees to do it, isn't it?
I know, but I'm 75, honey, and I do it.
And this is the kitchen after you.
Well, don't think I want to go in there, to be quite honest. Oh, dear.
Not that bad.
It is. I mean, look at this. Ah! Oh, my goodness. Oh. And all this, look at this. Oh, my goodness. This cook is disgusting.
I know it is, but it's one of those things that do it another time.
Yeah, but if you don't you understand, the more you leave it, the worse it's going to have to put more elbow grease in there. If you've done it nearly every day, or every other day, or once a week, it's not going to be nowhere near like this. I'm getting angry now. I mean, why are you laughing? Why are you laughing? Because this is disgusting.
This is my bathroom.
Oh, my goodness.
Look at this. Well, that doesn't come off. I don't lift that up, so I don't see it.
That's not the point. That would be full of germs, and that.
Because I just haven't got around to doing it.
Oh, my goodness. That's my motto. I haven't got around to doing it.
It's my granddaughter.
So, you know, you don't want her to come and play in all this mess, do you?
No, I don't. This was my daughter's bedroom, but it's now become a junk room since she moved out.
Oh.
And a rubbish room.
So, when your grandchildren come, Leslie, where do they stay?
because this is just full of germs. It's just not healthy.
She sleeps in my bed with me.
That's not good.
I would like to get a room for her.
I must admit, I felt sick. She just don't care. She just lets all the dirt there. Her grandchildren come in the dirt. She's making excuses. I don't know her a lot, but just lazy.
With only 4 days to turn things around in the flat, Victoria wants to prepare Leslie for the high standards she'll be expecting to reach during the clean.
When I do my toilets, I get every drop of water out, then I go in and out, in and out, in and out.
Well, that's stupid. Germs don't come up through the water.
Oh, if somebody's had a crocodile come up through the flipping water once.
Yeah, but germs don't.
Yes, they do. You're sitting near that. Germs don't just stay in the same place, honey.
Well, everybody's got germs.
Yeah, and that's why you should clean them away, shouldn't you? What's the point? In that case, we might just all sit back and live in filth, mightn't we?
It's annoyed me a little bit with her attitude. I think she thinks she's a bit better than me. She just wants to come in and say, you know, I can do it, so why can't you?
I just can't wait to get scrubbing and trying to teach her something.
In Portsmouth, full-time sales rep Louise, who spends 30 hours a week cleaning her house, will be tackling three of the rooms in Bachelor Tim's family home.
I love being the organiser, I love being the bossy one. I do that in my job, so I'm looking forward to applying that to Tim's house today, getting the bleach out, getting all the cleaning products out, maybe bossing Tim about a little bit, but I think he'll quite like it.
Louise wants to start with one of the dirtiest rooms, the bathroom. Although Tim cleans holiday camp toilets for a living, he only does his own bathroom twice a year.
Toilet brush. When was the last time you replaced that?
I don't replace it.
But it's got bits of poo on it.
No, it hasn't got bits of poo. It might have bits of toilet paper, but it hasn't got bits of poo on it.
Anything that goes into your toilet, do you think it's hygienic to have it sat there for years?
It should be changed sometimes, yeah.
At home, Louise gets through 2.5 litres of bleach every day to keep her bathroom and toilets spotless.
So where's that cloth come from, Tim?
It's up here. There's a white cloth I kept up.
So you're cleaning the bath with the dirty cloth?
No, it was clean. It hasn't been used on anything. It'll do for this job.
Absolutely gross.
It may surprise you to know, Louise, my current job is a cleaner.
You are a cleaner?
I work as a cleaner. I have to clean the ballroom toilets.
Are you joking,
mate? No, I'm a cleaner. I work in cleaning. It's a job. It's not the job I've done all my life, but it's the job I do currently.
I can't believe you're a cleaner.
Why?
Because you don't clean your own house.
Yeah, but I get measured on whether I've cleaned or not. That home, I live here.
Oh, my God, I can't believe that Tim is a cleaner. I'm absolutely gobsmacked.
One in 50 people in Britain is diagnosed with obsessive compulsive disorder. For some, this can manifest itself in an irrational fear of germs.
The thought of the dust, the particles in my house drives me crackers.
Although we come into contact with millions of harmless bacteria every day, for germaphobes with a fear of contamination, all bacteria are terrifying.
Oh my God, that's so bad.
What the hell have you trodden?
Mum of three, Hayley from Sussex, was diagnosed with OCD in 2007.
Having OCD, you are always checking and you are constantly on alert, like, and you worry about everything.
Now Hayley is joining fellow obsessive compulsive cleaners to scientifically test whether the outside world is as dirty as they fear.
It's a very important thing to me to push my boundaries and confront my fears, because I feel like the more I do that, it makes me have control over the illness as opposed to it having control over me.
Today, Hayley and the team are confronting their collective fear of germs, testing somewhere a third of us admit to only cleaning once a year, inside our cars.
Some people's cars skips on wheels. Absolutely. Can I say shit tips? When you get in somebody else's car and you see them stains, what is it? Is it feces or coffee?
Any kind of stain cannot be good.
For OCD diagnosed Leslie and daughter Tuesday, keeping a germ-free car is a daily obsession.
This car is now cleaner than when we bought it brand new.
Even having a cleaner than usual passenger can be a challenge.
Sit down then, but don't put your feet in yet.
Okay.
nobody comes in my car, and even when my mum does come in my car, when I absolutely have to take her somewhere, it's really traumatic for both of us because she has to anti-back her hands.
They are actually bleached, but, you know.
Yeah, I know, but I don't know why she's touching the meantime. I don't know where you've been. I'll shut the door, so don't touch her.
OK.
Order-obsessed Mark is equally extreme.
The car has to be immaculate. It's not unusual for me to take the wheels off of a car to clean them, which I think people do find completely bizarre.
And for perfectionist Richard...
Get me cleaning stuff.
Sanitising his car is a weekly ritual.
The car's an extension of the house, so therefore the car is as clean as the house.
My dog goes in the back, so that's what, you know, that's one of the reasons why I have to keep it so clean.
I've just sat in slobber.
He only goes in the boot, don't worry.
Does it poo in the boot?
No, Kayleigh, it doesn't poo in the car.
Before they put other people's cars to the test, they want to see how Richard's cleaning methods measure up.
It's going to take any grime and dirt off there and germs. It's got to get right in the corners and the edges.
When I'm cleaning my windows in my car, I always, like, put it down a little bit, the window, so I can clean the top as well, because when you put your window down, there's always a line there where the rubber's been. Yeah.
That's an exceptionally good idea.
See? See that little line there? Get on here, go on, get on
here. Oh, what were you thinking?
Bottom awful. Of the class.
This is my trusty air duster.
I'm impressed with that.
To me, it just seemed like you're just moving the dust around a little bit rather than getting rid of it, whereas a Hoover, even the point Sucks of it with a Hoover, you're just getting rid, then it's gone, isn't it? You know, that's right, so
I think, guys, I'm happy for you to do a bit of swabbing now.
To test for bacteria, they're using a device that checks hospital cleanliness levels.
Oh, look, she's going in the stitching. That's always a technique.
A reading of 500 or under means a surface is safe enough for food preparation.
Oh, what?
Shocking! 541.
No!
Terrible! Terrible.
Is it really?
Although Richard's car is almost clean enough to eat off, for these germaphobes, it's simply not clean enough.
You should be ashamed.
Yeah.
And you cleaned that?
And you've cleaned that?
A bleach wipe, a good solid bleach wipe, and it'd be much better.
I look at it and I'm like, yeah, that's clean. But you don't think about...
Yeah.
..the germs.
It definitely does make you think. It really does.
Mm.
Now they're ready to step out of their comfort zone and take on the general public's cars.
I can't touch I can't touch that. Look at the germs on
that. Touch it. Shall I lift you?
No, can you move that? I'm not touching that.
Back at Leslie's flat, Victoria's plan is to give the kitchen, bathroom and spare room a deep clean.
What cleaning materials you got then?
Oh, I've got all the cleaning materials.
Well, what kind? Because I know some really good ones. What ones you got? Show me.
This is my cleaning cupboard.
Not much here, is there? Got a Hoover?
Yeah.
Dustpan and brush?
Yeah.
Good. Have you got something you can kneel on when you scrub the floor? Oh, gee whiskins. No. And believe it or not, at my age, I do get down and scrub my kitchen floor.
That's what mops are for.
They don't get in the corners. Have you got any disinfectant?
Yes.
Where's that?
In the bathroom.
How much you got?
About half a large bottle.
I think here you're going to need more like a flipping container load, aren't you?
Given the 19 years of dirt to shift, stocking up on cleaning products is Victoria's first priority.
Right, cleaning. Only hope an establishment like this has got the good stuff. When did you last get all this gear?
Well, I just buy it as and when I think I need it.
Oh, right, well, that's not very often then.
There's a large bleach here.
Great, what makes that though?
Does it matter? It's bleach.
Yeah, it's not...
Bleach is bleach.
No, it's not strong.
They're all the same.
No, they're not.
They are.
They're not. If you don't have the best products, you're just not going to get the best results, are you? I've been looking forward to today's cleaning, because I love to see the difference. I'm looking forward to this, because it's so dirty. But the difference is going to be amazing. So we've got cloths, dusters...
Floor cleaner.
Floor cleaner. I think you need a flamethrower.
No. Oh, shit, I've hard work. I need a rest after this. I don't know about going back and start cleaning.
We'll be back. We'll be back.
In the West Midlands, Victoria wants to make a start on Leslie's kitchen, where the walls and ceiling have 19 years of grime and nicotine stains, and despite a refit just over a year ago, the oven and hob are thick with grease.
We're going to tackle the worst thing. What would you think was the worst thing in your kitchen?
The cooker.
Precisely. So, right, so where's this? Thank you. Now, what we've got to do is you keep doing this until you've got a nice thick lump you can wipe off. Look, it's cut. See what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You're beginning to see the top of the cooker now. Now, come on, you're going to be doing this. Do the edges and along there.
Mm-hmm.
With a bit of elbow grease to it. And then you want a nice hot flannel to wipe away. Look.
What? Yeah, I know.
Are you looking, Honey Munch?
Yes.
There you go. Nobody get angry at me. It's not me. This is your work, babe. Don't forget the sump bit.
She's like a tornado.
I ought to start on next hit, actually.
She just dash.
You need a bit of elbow grease. It will come off.
She needs to chill out a bit.
You done this little bit as well? It's just a little bit under there. Look. Oh.
After just half an hour, 56-year-old Leslie is struggling to keep up with 75-year-old Victoria.
You want a cup of tea?
Oh, I wouldn't drink tea here, honey. Sorry, I don't. I wouldn't. Perhaps in 2 days.
I'll have one of myself, then.
Well, do what you like. Ah!
What?
Nothing. I've got a thing to take away my aggravation here. I just want to go da-da-da and clean everything. Everything I touch and I don't want to leave because it's still... Oops, like that. I've never seen anything left go so quite so bad. It's not that big to keep clean. You can do a little bit each day. It's just no excuse. I don't think it's any excuse at all. Right, so we'll just rinse that off and see. See that? You can see your face in it.
Yeah.
I've missed a bit. Hang on, I'm sorry. I've got to do that bit I missed. It's annoying me.
Victoria, do you want to sit down?
Yeah.
Nice clean towel here for you to sit on.
Leslie finally persuades Victoria to take a break.
Obviously, I'm only here for a few days, but when I go, I'd like to feel that I've done something to help, give you a different, you know, outlook on keeping the place clean. Because I know you love your grandkids. Just think of them as well. I have seen a lot of dirt here, and the kids are touching it all the time.
I think my mind had already started to go round to wanting to get
That's why you asked for help here.
Which is why I asked for help.
Right, and because you felt it was too overwhelming in your condition, with whatever your condition is and...
Well, yeah, I suffer from depression. And also, 2 years ago, I was diagnosed with sleep apnea.
What's that? I'm very ignorant, my body.
It's you actually stop breathing in your sleep. That is one of the reasons why I was tired all the time.
Right.
Because I wasn't getting sleep. It's difficult, you know.
Yeah.
I joke about it.
Yeah, I've noticed that. And I took umbrage to that when I first came. I thought you weren't serious.
No, but I am.
But... Stop me crying now. so we're going to work together here?
Well, yeah.
Oh, bless your heart.
I'm going to do it.
Don't stop me crying. I realise a lot of things happened to her in her life. She's had this kind of health problem. So I can understand her a lot more now. And we've got really close there, and I feel good about that.
I'm glad I sort of got everything out with Victoria.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Because now she understands me better and isn't so judgmental.
There's another lottery ticket there. That's 18 months out of date.
Let's hope it wasn't a winner.
In Portsmouth, Louise is tackling Tim's cluttered front room, which she's been too ashamed to invite anyone into for years.
Do you not feel like just getting hold of all this stuff and just put it straight in the skip?
No.
Absolutely no way.
No. Not, that's what the trouble is. I don't feel that I can throw it out without going through it.
It's just been really frustrating for me. There's so much stuff that I would literally just chuck in the bin without a single thought. But for Tim, they've really meant something, so I've tried my best to be patient.
Tim and his wife separated 7 years ago, and their two children are now grown up, but many of their family items remain.
Is there any particular reason why you do keep hold of certain things? Because you seem to have, like, an attachment to maybe family life from, I don't know, 10, 15 years ago.
Maybe because 10 to 15 years ago, I still had a family life as a family life, and I wasn't on my own.
Yeah. To me, it feels like you're living in somebody else's house, even though it's your house.
Yes, I see where you come from with that.
In the hope of inspiring him to get rid of more, Louise shows Tim photos of her minimalist home.
That's my lounge.
That's how it is all the time.
That's my kitchen.
It's quite anonymous.
Anonymous? Is that what you said?
When I say anonymous, if I was looking at a new development and they took me to the show home, that's what you'd see.
That's what I want it to look like.
Yeah, you wouldn't have to take much out of that, and it would be nobody know who lived there, would they?
That's probably true.
You know.
But I like it like that. See, for me, I come in here and I don't know who lives in your house either, because it's just full of stuff that doesn't tell me anything about you.
If it had just been left to Louise, virtually everything would have been in that skip. We did have a happy time to live in here, so it's not that easy just to say, well, that's just a tacky ornament, let's throw it away. It's not. It's got memories.
We all come into contact with millions of germs every day. For most people, this isn't an issue, as they don't usually cause a healthy person harm. But for some of those with OCD, it can be a major challenge. At a service station outside London, Hayley and her team of obsessive cleaners are facing some of their worst fears and testing the public's vehicles for bacteria.
They're all gonna be dirty.
White van man, you know, eating his bacon butty in the morning or his egg sandwiches or whatever, and then straight back on the steering wheel. And...
Yeah.
70% of Brits admit to eating in their vehicles. And the first under scrutiny is a white van.
If it meant going to the hospital in a white van, I'm sorry, leave me at home, let me get on with my symptoms. It's not happening, is it?
No.
Can I come in if you just... I'll hop in there. Thank you, darling. Can somebody... Yeah. I can't touch
come on,
that. I can't touch that. Look, just move that, because I can't touch that.
Freeze.
Yeah, that's it. There you are.
Oh, it's really bad in here. I mean, I wouldn't bring my dog in here, sweetheart. It stinks.
As they did with Richard's car earlier, they're testing with a bacterial measuring device used in hospitals to ensure the highest levels of hygiene.
Yeah, it's well mucky, Luke, isn't it? Look at that.
A reading of 500 or less means a surface is safe enough for food preparation.
Joking. It's 78.
Yeah, that's cleaner than yours.
That is really good.
Yeah, see?
The white van seat registered just 78, compared to the 541 previously recorded on Richard's steering wheel.
Thank you very much.
Hi. Sorry to interrupt your little motorway break.
Right.
On average, on a weekly basis, how often would you clean your car?
It's definitely not weekly. It's probably not monthly.
She's not alone, with a third of Brits admitting to only cleaning inside their cars once a year.
Wow.
It's an incredibly low 15 for her much-used indicators.
Well, that's almost surgical, to be honest with you.
On average, Brits use some form of private hire 12 times a year, but for a germaphobe, it can be unthinkable.
Me, personally, I haven't been in a cab for years because there's so many people in it. You know, at night, the people who are drunk, there's probably been sick in there, a bit of faeces, a little bit of wee. You know, you never know, because a taxi man doesn't clean like us. It's four! No!
Anything under 500 is clean.
Well done.
Who's got OCD, me or you?
Yeah, that's brilliant. I'm starting to worry now.
I'm ashamed to say that I thought you were going to be really dirty devils.
Clean cab. People like to get in it.
I'm proud.
Get bigger tips, maybe.
You'll be having big tips off me, lads.
So will the day's surprising results have a lasting impact on the obsessive cleaners?
You can see that a lot of things aren't actually as bad as you might think. Just because it looks like it's a bit dirty doesn't mean it's full of germs. You're going to die of the plague from touching it.
It reiterates the fact that it is just a fault that I'm having. As someone diagnosed with OCD, it's been a real eye-opener. Even though I've seen this today and had the proof that, you know, taxis and things like that aren't as dirty as you would expect, still got to be anti-vac in my hands and my car and things, you know?
I think I'm going to take my car to Tuesday's car cleaning service.
Yeah, definitely.
Halfway through the clean in the Midlands, pensioner Victoria is tackling Leslie's bathroom.
I'll tell you what I do.
I go up and down as fast as you can.
She's hoping to convert her to a remarkably thorough way of cleaning a toilet.
You want to take out as much water as you can from what's in there. Squeeze it out really, really tight.
It's an awful lot of work.
Yeah, but only if you leave it this long. So I spray it all around, OK? And then a bit more of that. OK? But OK, so you have a go. See, that's where your germs live, in that little black bit. Mm. Have you ever cleaned your toilet?
The way a normal person cleans a toilet, yes.
Well,
God, put
what do you mean normal?
Put a bit of bleach round. I think that toilet process is a bit excessive. There's no need to go to the full emptying the water out the bowl, etc.
It's really just a ritual now to me.
I think it's a ritual you need to get out of.
No. See what I mean? Lovely. Sparkling clean, yep. Darling.
Just come up lovely and clean.
Yeah, good.
Although Leslie is getting stuck in to get all the rooms finished in time, Victoria has called in professional help with the walls and ceilings, which have 19 years of grease and nicotine stains.
I would start on the ceiling. That needs doing really badly. And work my way down to get the whole thing kind of sparkling clean.
While the steam cleaner gets to work, the ladies make a start on Leslie's daughter's old room.
I shouldn't get this much rubbish after a rock festival, would you?
Victoria wants to turn it into a clean and safe bedroom for Leslie's granddaughter when she visits.
So we're going to get all this muck out here.
Yep.
Because your granddaughter's given me here, it's going to be sparkling clean, isn't it?
At home, Victoria uses almost 200 cotton buds a month on her window frames.
And this. And get in the corners you can't. Right, oh, look, see? Lovely big bit of dirt there. Good for the garden.
Come on, Q-tips.
There we go. I think she's getting the cleaning bud now. And begin to see that little bit of pride creeping in. And hopefully she'll keep it up.
It is really satisfying, isn't it?
Getting a warm glow.
I can actually see white. I'm comfortable with Victoria now, and we're having fun. And I didn't think cleaning could be fun.
Oh, I say.
In Portsmouth, Tim's reluctance to throw things away is easing.
Yeah, I've got a couple more things I was going to chuck out, I think.
Feels good, doesn't it?
No, it don't feel good. It's
yeah,
just...
it does.
With the draining board cleared, Louise can make a start on Tim's sink, which hasn't been cleaned in 8 months.
How often do you do your sink then, Louise?
I clean my sink every single time I've used it.
So every single time you've used it?
Yeah. I can't leave any, like, water marks, or I won't ever leave my sink with water. You know, like, the droplets of water in the bottom?
Yeah.
I'd always clean it and dry it so that, you know, it's really shiny. When I go to put my cleaning cloth away in the cupboard, sometimes I'll drop a few bits of water on the floor, so then I have to clean my floor again.
Honest?
Yeah. But then, obviously, it means I've used my sink again, so then I'm in a vicious circle because then I've got to clean my sink again when I've finished. So I can end up doing it 2 or 3 times.
But that vicious circle business, it can take over a life, so that becomes more important than lots of other things in your life.
Yeah, no, you're probably right. I wish I could chill out a bit sometimes, but I just like things perfect all the time. But
I don't think you can never get perfection. You can get close.
Try.
I know, you can try, but you can never actually achieve it. The best you can do is keep getting back to a good standard.
Yeah.
Soap suds.
I've never seen anybody put soap suds in the bin.
Well,
I would like to come away from this experience maybe being a bit more chilled out with my routine, and maybe just leaving, throwing caution to the wind and leaving a coffee cup in the sink.
In the West Midlands, Victoria is putting the finishing touches to Leslie's flat after 4 days of deep cleaning. 19 years of grease and grime have been removed from the kitchen walls. And decorators are preparing the spare room for Leslie's granddaughter, Arissa, who's on her way to see it with Mum Christine. 4 days ago, this room was a dumping ground, and so dirty it was off-limits to 4-year-old Arissa.
Wow.
Pink.
Yeah.
Pink for my little princess.
Look at that, Arissa. Do you like it?
This is great here. She's heavy.
I'm ever so glad now, but at least she can... I know she's got somewhere nice and clean. And you can even see out the garden now. Yeah. Out the clean windows.
In the bathroom, 19 years of dirt has been scrubbed away and the toilet emptied and scoured.
Nice and bright again, isn't it?
It is. Now it's clean, it's...
easier to keep clean.
You've got to keep it clean.
You're going to keep it clean.
In the kitchen, Leslie didn't believe in the need to clean the floor or hob, as you don't eat off them. But now the whole room is spotless and hygienic.
So everything's lovely, easy to wipe down when you're finished.
Mm-hmm. It's been great having somebody to motivate me. Would you drink a cup of tea in here with me now?
Do you know what? I think I actually might.
I can't remember the last time I actually saw it this clean. It's amazing. I'm just so proud of my mum for getting down and cleaning everywhere.
I genuinely believe that I will keep this place clean. Might not be as finicky as Victoria, but it will be clean.
Give Nanny a kiss and say thank you for doing all the cleaning.
You can say thank you.
Thank you, Nanny.
It's a new beginning, babe.
Yep.
Really, I've got to see a few tears here at all. Quite a lot of emotion, actually. I'm quite surprised. It's completed and I can see the result. I think Leslie has had a wake-up call and she's gonna... I think she's just taking pride of it now.
Louise has spent the last few days getting rid of 7 years' worth of clutter and dirt from three of the rooms in Tim's house. She's also been trying to win him over to some of her more unusual cleaning practices.
And then just go over it and just make it shiny and polish it. Yeah, you could twist, do what you want. So you're getting into it now, aren't you?
Oh, it's easy.
Are you going to keep this up once I've gone?
Not this.
You're not going to buff? It's good fun, though.
Soon, Tim's daughter, Lisa, will be coming to see the results of the clean. But there's one obstacle left for Louise to overcome. The front room unit.
Right, the reason I don't have any... The reason I don't have anything all over shelves like this is because then you could come in on a daily basis and literally just sweep it and it takes 2 minutes.
Tim's wife Sue moved out 7 years ago, leaving behind shelves of knickknacks he hasn't wanted to shift.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Does Tim like donkeys?
Tim doesn't mind donkeys.
But does Tim want donkeys in his living room 365 days of the year?
Tim is not fussed about having donkeys in his living room.
So we'll put them in the box. For me, though, I just think you don't need to have everything round you all the time.
If there's nothing in the display unit, it might as well be in the furniture shop.
Is that an option?
Finally agreeing to clear the cabinet of family ornaments, Tim will wait to hear what his daughter thinks when she sees the results of the big clean.
I think it might take Lisa's reaction to actually make Tim realise what's been achieved in a relatively short period of time.
Oh, hello, Lisa,
Dad.
Come in.
How are you?
All right, thanks. And you?
I'm all right.
4 days ago, Tim was so ashamed of his cluttered front room that it was out of bounds to visitors.
Blimey, this is lovely. It looks like a living
room. Better, doesn't it?
It looks a lot better. It's like a living room again.
So is there anything that you've walked near and thought, oh, that's disappeared?
All the ornaments from the top shelf over on that unit.
OK. But do you miss them or have you just noticed that they're not there?
I've just noticed that they're not there.
Do you still feel like it feels like a family room?
Yeah, because it's obviously my dad's lived here for 20-odd years, so there's still... it does still feel like a family room.
In the kitchen, every surface was piled high and hadn't been cleaned in 8 months.
Right, Lisa, what do you think to this?
Blimey, it's really nice. Crikey, you can actually see the draining board, everything is really lovely. It looks like a proper kitchen again now, where you can actually sit there and have your breakfast.
The bathroom, which only got a deep clean twice a year, was thick with dirt and mould.
Blimey, look at this. This is lovely and clean. I actually don't recognise the bathroom, Dad.
Don't you?
It hasn't been this clean for a long, long time. I'm really proud of it now. I hope you are, Dad, and I hope you're going to try and keep it like this.
I said I'm going to try and keep up to this standard.
Right, Tim, thanks very much for everything. It's been a pleasure.
Oh, thank you, Louise, because this wouldn't have got done without you.
Oh, well, you're more than welcome, and I just hope you keep it up.
I'm going to try. I am really going to try hard. She's brought to me the, you know, the realisation that you just can't let things slide. You've just got to stay on top of it. Whether I've had any effect on her or not, I don't know. I hope that she will sort of just ease back a little bit.
I think spending time with Tim has kind of changed my sort of opinion on things. For me, I kind of think that if all the cleaning's not done, then maybe the world's going to kind of collapse in, which is, I think I've realised, is total nonsense.
I'm proud of you for doing it.
Well, thanks, Lise.
Really proud. Because it's a nice home. You now can open the door wide when people are at the door instead of just poking your head through and not letting anyone see it.
Yeah, well, I can actually let people in there if I need to let
and the
people
front
in.
Room.
To go in the front room.
Yeah.
Next time on Obsessive Compulsive Cleaners...
I'm a collector, not a hoarder.
It's just rot and it's dirt and it's... Oh, it's disgusting.
I'll take you into the living room now.
See, I could not have a monkey on the back of my sofa.
They're your shorts, sweetie.
Yeah.
Find somewhere for them.
Clive needs to put his hand down his pants, find his balls and make a decision.
Support information for the issues raised can be found at channel4.com/support. Coming up, they've got to sing, dance and act. It's the triple threat darling and they need someone to fill the dancing shoes at Top Hat. The Sound of Musicals continues.